The program contains adult material. There's nothing adult about this show. It's totally juvenile. What is this, Robin?
The following is an encore presentation of The Howard Stern Show.
In this way.
Whatever. What do I look like, a black guy? Hey, good evening, everybody. It's Saturday night, 11 o'clock. What a great show we have for you tonight. Oh, man.
Tell us that lineup.
I tell you, what a great show. Although you wouldn't know it from reading the newspaper reports on this show. Gee, the review, you know, the reviewers never gave me good reviews on my radio program, nor do I expect them to give me good reviews on my TV show, but it's just kind of embarrassing. It kind of gets to you when critics can't admit that at least something different's going on here on Saturday nights.
Well, I thought it was interesting that now the radio show is good, the television show is bad.
Yeah, this TV show has made us good on radio. It's a fascinating phenomenon.
It is. We at least got good on radio now.
All the guys who wrote negative reviews about this show, first of all, I want to crown myself as the king of television. Because number one, thank you. Because number one, we killed in the ratings.
Yes, we did. That doesn't look too stupid.
It's kind of heavy, you know? But we killed in the ratings.
I mean, when we say that on radio, you actually don't put on.
I know. Well, for TV, I decided to get visual. But hey, we saved Channel 9 in the ratings. The first time they've ever seen an 8 share ever.
Yes. On any night.
On any night. Oh, I don't even think the Mets get an 8 share. We finally do something good.
Yeah.
And every reviewer, the New York Post, says I blow. The Daily News was most scathing, of course, which was David Hinckley's review of this show. And, you know,
He's had a vendetta against us for a long time.
People who know about vendettas, I've invited onto this show. I've invited tonight Sam Kinison.
Yeah.
David Brenner.
All right.
And who else are we having on? Joe
Walsh
is going to finish off with a couple old Eagles songs.
And what's that? Don Henley will get upset? Is that what happens?
Oh, yeah. We're going to make Don Henley of the Eagles angry tonight when Joe comes out and does Desperado, which is Don's song.
Who the hell does he think that he is?
Hey, let's bring Kinison out.
All right.
Kinison. Sam Kinison.
He can help us with his review. There he is.
There he is.
The Dark Lord.
You might want to welcome the king of television, Sam. Sam looks good, too. He looks slim.
Look at you. What is this?
You look good.
I like this outfit.
You look great, man. Crown, man. I feel like I feel like there should be some imperial butter.
Sam is a good guy. I mean, Sam said.
Did you have, like, some butter before I came out?
Sam, your crown is very beautiful as well.
Yeah.
I just got to say.
Yeah.
Beautiful pirate crown.
You know what I think is interesting? That he has those in all different colors.
He does. He really does.
But nobody knew that before. Now they know.
Let me say something. Sam is a good man. Number one, most of the reviewers said no one will appear on our show.
Is that right?
Right. Because we're mean-spirited. But Sam is a good friend.
There you go.
Flew in from the Montreal Comedy Festival for this.
Thank you, and I appreciate
that. And left another country under another name because I have to serve somebody.
Thank you, man. And Sam, of course, was asleep back in the dressing room.
I heard you pass out as soon as you got here.
I was dead tired.
I can't take this.
Oh, there it goes.
All I got was negative reviews on this show. I tuned
up. Yeah, but you killed.
Did you see it?
Yeah. No, I heard the reviews. I was working last Saturday night. I didn't even see it.
I tune up and down.
So I'm like wide open for this. First time I've been part of this.
I tune up and down the television dial all week because I had all week off.
Yeah.
I watch late night television. There's nothing going on. There is nothing to watch on television.
The Rick D show? You mean you haven't found a new way to watch late night television?
Hey, Rick D's, eat me! I mean that. Look at this. Every review is negative.
Hey, well, he didn't even get
reviews. I was at the Montreal Comedy Festival.
And what did they say?
Bob Morton from Letterman Show.
Yeah, what did he say?
First of all, he said your last Letterman appearance was the most brilliant you've ever had.
Thank you.
He thought the show was great. He thought it was hysterical. Get that close. I'm talking good about Howard.
Yeah, right.
Get right in there.
Oh.
Yeah, we don't want to miss any of these words.
Morty thought it was brilliant.
Thank you.
People out in L.A. thought it was brilliant. The comics are all up in Montreal were talking about
Maybe you shouldn't say the word brilliant, though.
Yeah. No, I did. I thought it was very hip.
Say brilliant, though, the critics hate that.
Yeah, you can't say Howard's brilliant.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Apparently.
Let me say something that'll make Sam happy.
Okay.
Okay?
Good.
I'm going to say something that'll make you very happy.
My wife has someone been executed?
Yeah, right.
Oh. Somebody experienced death in prison?
let me say something. Let me say something that will make Sam very, very happy.
Okay, I'm waiting.
My wife and I took in all the movies this week.
Yeah.
I saw the new movie Ghost, which I thought was great.
Excellent.
Ghost was great. I thought Whoopi was really good.
I have to agree with you 100%.
Okay. I went and saw the movie. What other movies did I see besides Ghost? I saw,
Did you see the Bill Murray?
No, I'm not going to go see that.
Ghost Dad.
Days of Thunder?
Days of Thunder I saw. It wasn't so good. But
it's
it was okay.
All right.
It was all right.
It was 2 hours.
It was a little long. Too many races.
Duvall was good.
Except
that he can't seem to act without the tongue in his mouth.
I seem to like...
Tongue's always out, isn't it?
I always like all movies. I'm a fan of movies.
You always go to every movie. You don't care how bad it is. You sit through it.
So I go to Ford Fairlane with my wife. All right? I said, I want to see Dice's new movie.
Get ready to see me smile.
You're ready to be dazzled, right? Yeah. Because it's the Dice movie.
Hey, it's going to be the biggest movie of the year. Oh,
top grossing movie ever.
40 million the first weekend. I'm going to be the biggest box office star bar none of all time. Oh.
Don't you love when people do bad?
Yeah.
So anyway... I go to this movie with my wife.
Yes.
We sit through the first 10, 15 minutes, and we're laughing at how bad it is. Because it's funny that it's this bad. 20 minutes go by,
Doesn't get any better. The joke about being bad is gone.
45 minutes into it, I turn to my wife. I said, I can take no more. I throw up on the lady in front of me.
Oh, no.
There's seven people in the theater. I walked out. I thought, I have never seen a worse
movie.
You've
never walked out in a moment.
And the other seven said, we'd like to go, but we can't walk. We took our chairs and we came in.
They took the batteries.
Our families abandoned us here. They're shopping in the mall.
Dice's movie was harder to take than a cement enema.
Well, there's a review.
Because I know Sam hates Dice.
Well, I saw David Sheehan's review out in L.A. on NBC Channel 4. He says, I have two words to say about this movie. Forget it.
That's it.
That was good. I haven't seen that, but I've got to go see it.
As bad as my reports on cable.
You better hurry.
But so anyway, I went and I talked to the guy in the movie theater, and he said they made $69 for the day, as opposed to $450 with all their other movies. So the movie is not making any money, Sam.
Oh, that's just hard. It's playing at the Vogue in Hollywood. I don't know if you know where the Vogue is, but you don't go down there unless you're packing a gun.
Right.
It's in one of these theaters. It's like this should be playing like you know.
Did it make you happy that his movie was bad?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, you know. All right, so Sam's happy. That's all.
I'm happy.
Also, that I'll give you some more good news.
Give me more good news.
Fox has decided not to release his concert film.
I heard this. This was in the paper.
Yeah.
Hey, let's have a drink. How are we doing? Are we drinking or are we staying?
We're back to day one again.
Oh, should read People Magazine.
We'll be back with Sam Kinison.
Friends.
Speaking of People Magazine, I want to talk to David Brenner about bad reviews because he got a bad one in People Magazine.
Oh.
And I've arranged for the woman
this place is.
Exactly. I want him to come out and talk with us. Sam's
going to
stay with us. Joe Walsh is coming up, and I got a commercial we'd like to see coming up as well. So stay right with us. We'll be right back. Kinison,
yeah.
Who, of course, you were on Arsenio the night I was on Letterman. I was actually
shocked. That's why I missed your show.
Yeah, that's what happened.
Yeah,
I was shocked.
You were on opposite, yeah.
I was shocked that Sam did Arsenio.
Well, Arsenio and I have had a war for, 2 years.
And didn't you punch him out or something?
It was at the China Club. We had we almost had a physical confrontation. And that was how it was put.
Yeah. What was that?
Like knights jousting.
Yes.
You know.
Was it because of his big gums? Was that why? Were you sexually attracted to his gums? Was that the problem?
Well, originally there was a misunderstanding about the MTV Awards, which I was. They told me that I was originally supposed to host it, and he ended up hosting it. And I said, "Hey, fine, pal. I've known you since 1980. Thanks, buddy."
Right.
Oh, yes,
and that's where it originally broke off.
You felt that Arsenio had stuck you in the back because he took over your MTV hosting.
Yeah, exactly.
But you did the show.
Well, here's what happened. I was supposed to do Carson.
Right.
I see Jay Leno in Vegas. Jay goes, "Hey, Sam, how come you never on with me?
You're always on with Johnny. You know my beef is, you're always on with Johnny."
Yeah. So I said, "Okay.
Who are you doing?"
We're both trying to do a bad Jay Leno impression.
And because of Malika's recent... thing that's in litigation and their tragedy or whatever, or assault.
Can I say something? I just hope that that jerk goes to prison for 50 years.
Believe me, he will. Right. And because of that, you know, I was supposed to be on the Carson show the same night you were on Letterman.
Carson
last Tuesday.
You. Okay.
Yeah, I'm booked.
All right.
So I'm supposed to call in to this guy named Jim McCauley, who's the talent coordinator like Frank Gannon is right. for Letterman, for Carson.
Right.
This guy, I call him up, and I go, yeah, he wants to go with the material. He goes, well, no. What I wanted to tell you was that, you know, NBC feels like because of your recent publicity with your situation that maybe it's better that you don't do the television show for a couple months.
NBC didn't want you on because you were involved in controversy.
Yes. And I said, hey, you know what I said? I need to be on now to show people I'm not the jerk that People Magazine made me out to look like.
Well,
they opened the interview in People Magazine with sexual violent themes that run through Kinison's acts, absolutely happened in his own home, but this time there were no laughs.
Right. Oh, great.
It's like, oh, yeah. Like, I've encouraged to go out and rape people. That's
because
my theme.
Because you do comedy.
Theme of my comedy. Go out and rape women. No.
I never heard you say that.
I'm a defender of women's rights. Everyone knows that.
Well, I read the people.
Part I thought was interesting of the People Magazine article was that you didn't even call, and you went out and did a nightclub act.
I was never even... again, people, you know, Sam Kinison is not available for comment. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, you know, it's only because they want to write what they want to paint the picture they want. It was another opportunity for them to jump on them and paint me black and paint
I resent is
the darkest guy in Hollywood and you know,
people
the guy's so heartless, he's out the next night.
Yeah.
I snuck out of my house because there were four camera crews at 11 o'clock. Filming my house live. I snuck out the back of my house and you saw the house.
If somebody's raped, why would they have a camera crew at your house the next day?
Because they want to be on the scene, man. They're at the scene, 11 o'clock, where the violence took place.
Oh,
and I snuck out of my house and I went down to a place called Spice. Then I knew the owners and they took care of me and I was hiding out from the press because I couldn't make a statement, which I can't make now, but I hadn't even talked to the police or district attorney at that point.
But your girlfriend's okay.
Yeah, Malika's great. She did the right thing. And again, I want to say... And I know the law in New York is if you have a gun, you go to jail for a year. But keep some kind of loaded weapon in your house. And if somebody tries to assault you or rape you, shoot to kill, man. Blow their head off.
Whoa.
They don't deserve to live. They're scum, man.
Well, I agree
with
you. This idiot who did this deserves... is he going to go to prison?
Yeah, he's up on 5 counts right now.
Good.
He's
good.
He's looking at 40 years.
And just because a guy does comedy doesn't mean... Or he has a wild act. Don't hold it against him in People Magazine and
Magazine's a rag.
Yeah, it's a rag. But
and,
hey, speaking of rags,
they make National Enquirer look like decent journalism.
Then we got
National Enquirer was actually better to me than People Magazine.
Now remember that.
Remember you saying that because
better.
We are now going to bring out David Brenner.
David Brenner.
And there's a theme to this.
Man, I love
because Brenner was burned by People Magazine.
He was panned by People Magazine critic.
There's David Brenner. Come
here
on.
David, step up. Step up to our microphone.
David, take a seat. David, I'm glad you're here.
One of the masters. One of the true masters.
One of the true masters.
Here's the story with People Magazine.
Oh, what a rag. You hate him as much as I do, huh?
Mine goes back. Now.
Okay.
You know, they don't forget. All right, here's what happened. So they panned a book that I wrote, and I don't mind panning a book. I mean, some people don't like your stuff. That's all right. They don't like the stuff. All right, that's fine. But the woman says in her review that she got 10 laughs. I wanted to write to her and say, look, I'll tell you what.
I got one better for you. I got the woman on the phone.
How could
I got
better?
The woman on the phone who gave you the bad review.
Oh, yeah? Great.
And we can confront her.
I want to make her an offer.
Okay.
All right? You got her on the phone? No, seriously. Right. I want to make her an offer.
Can you bring her up on the phone?
I like the way she says that.
All right.
Okay,
hi.
Great.
Hi.
Who are we talking to?
Who is this?
I'm the reviewer. My name's Sarah Nelson.
Sarah, hi. Now listen.
Sound like a man.
Yes,
yeah,
sound like
no, it's Sarah.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, she has a very deep voice.
I just have a deep voice.
Sarah, I really enjoy your magazine.
Now,
right, Sarah, here's what I want to ask you,
right,
Sarah. I don't mind you panning, you know, my book. You understand? Because that everyone has their opinion. I got all good reviews except yours. I've had maybe 10 bad reviews in my whole career. Yours is one of them. Okay, it's a distinction for you. Now, here's the question, though.
What?
I don't mind you not liking my book, but if you tell me that you only got 10 laughs, what I'm willing to do, pick out arbitrarily 100 English-speaking people in this country, all right?
Right.
If any one of them gets 10 or less laughs from my book, I will give you $10,000. If they get more than 10, then your magazine has to give $10,000 to a charity I choose.
Well, now, wait a minute. First of all, I'm a freelancer, so I can't speak for the magazine.
All right, then you give the
$10,000. What didn't you like about the book, Sarah?
What?
What didn't you like about the book?
Well, I did say that there were some laughs in it.
10, you said.
And I thought, generally, that the stuff where you're telling stories is a lot funnier than when you're telling jokes. Like these lists, David. I mean... When you're in Poland, don't ask them when they're getting the one library book back. I mean, that's a joke.
Uh-oh, you're laughing.
Well, Sam did laugh.
Sir, excuse me.
Great.
This appeals to my racial comedy.
I took every country apart, didn't I?
What?
I took every country apart.
Yeah, you didn't
just...
Yeah,
I'm just
well,
big
I know,
on Poland.
I mean,
it's just that reviewers, you know, I got
to... Why has she made anybody laugh? What makes her such a great judge of comedy?
She has the right to do that.
Did you see our first television show, David?
Yeah, I did see it.
Okay, now, I got to say something.
I saw Drew Belzer. I thought it was terrific.
And that's as much of the show as you saw?
It was different television.
Yeah, that's what
I wouldn't be here if I didn't like the show.
So, Sarah... What? The problem with reviewers is it drives people crazy in that you didn't laugh, but, like, it makes it seem like no one will laugh at the book.
Well, no, no,
well,
the point
you
is...
know, my name is signed to it. You know, it says, I mean, it's obviously one person's opinion.
What comic makes you laugh?
Well, Sam makes me laugh.
Sam makes you laugh?
Yeah.
I see. Is there anybody else?
Anybody else?
Yeah.
Wayne Newton.
Well...
She doesn't. She's not a real fan of comedy. It doesn't sound like.
You know what? Jokes. You know, guys who tell jokes don't make me laugh so much as like, you know, people who do sketch comedy. I find that funnier generally. And I thought the stuff in David's book that was sort of more of a sketch, you know, that were stories, were funnier than things that were kind of throwaway jokes.
The reviews really.
Did she start off by saying, "I don't usually like sketch comedy or joke comedy"?
She just ripped me a new
navel.
Navel.
I ripped a new navel. I'll tell you what. Let me do a commercial here, and then we'll come back with Stutter and John and some of his interviews. Quickly plug David Brenner's book, the one that's
not funny, according to People magazine. It's a very serious book. Ten laughs, he said.
Let me say something to Sam. We were talking during the commercial. I'm worried about Sam in the sense that you were accused of having an illegal gun in your house.
Yes.
And I just want to make a statement that thank God this guy had an illegal gun in his house. And thank God that he was able to have a gun where he could protect his girlfriend.
He's a criminal. He's a criminal.
I'm a criminal, yeah.
Is there any chance that you could be prosecuted for this?
No. But let me tell you something. California's different than New York. But you can always get lawyers, man. You can't get a life back.
Amen.
I just want to say one thing. It's totally different topic.
Yeah?
Frank Sinatra's in trouble. We read a report last week, didn't we, Robin, in the news?
He was at some party.
And
over
he was,
in London?
According to the article I read in the paper, he was babbling incoherently. Now, I can't believe this myself. I don't believe it's true. But here's a commercial we'd like to see just in case it is true. All right? Take a look at this.
Okay.
All right.
All right. According to the supermarket tabloids, Frank Sinatra has Alzheimer's, but it hasn't slowed him down. Frank's new album, I Remember What's Her Name, is available to you now. Hear Frank attempt these great hits.
Luck be an egg cream tonight. And tractors, love and tractors, I've got you under my house.
How does it go? I know how it goes. Start the music again, please.
Old Blue Eyes has gone blank.
Chicago, Chicago, it's a wonderful band.
Old Empty Head sings My Funny Valentine.
My funny turpentine. Sweet comic Frankenstein.
Here, my kind of town.
My kind of town, Galveston is.
Here, interviews with Frank himself.
Mr. Sinatra.
Yeah?
What's your favorite movie?
The Manchurian Restaurant and The Man with the Golden Nose, hey?
Could you name some of your good Hollywood friends?
Well, we definitely hung with the six-pack, definitely ran around with those people. Shirley MacLaine, she was wonderful. Hazel Bishop, Jimmy Davis Jr., Don Martin. Hey, don't tell me I can't remember these people, huh? What is this
Mr. Sinatra, what did you have for breakfast?
Hey, cuckoo baby, don't talk down to me, huh, Clyde? Asking me these weird questions.
Something in the way she cooks.
Order now. And with any luck, Frank will remember to send you your record.
Moonlight in Japan.
Call now. Dial 1-800-I-FORGOT.
Now get out of here or I'll have my legs broken.
Dial 1-800-I-FORGOT.
To tell you the truth, I can't remember when I started forgetting.
Order now.
She's getting bitchy. It's that time of month.
Yeah.
That's why the lady is a shoe.
I don't know, huh?
We don't know.
I hope Frank has a good sense of humor.
You better hope he has a good sense of humor.
Yeah.
We're just kidding, though. I'm sure
we're
fine.
Just kidding.
You better hope he remembers that he has a good sense of humor.
Exactly. Who knows? But anyway, hey, listen, we got to take a break.
Yeah.
We come back. Stuttering John's going to join us.
Great.
Yeah.
He interviewed, let me tell you the three people he interviewed. Roy Scheider.
Oh, good.
Wow.
One. Yeah, good
Jaws
one.
Okay.
Good one.
He drives Roy Scheider crazy. And Joey Ramone.
Joey Ramone.
And I
your
promise
illegitimate
you.
Your illegitimate son.
Yes. I promise you, when you see these interviews, they're like none you've seen before.
All right.
You'll love.
I'm hanging out for this. David and I are here. Yeah. We're not
we are the most
go.
Irritating show on television.
All
There's
right.
no two ways about it. Yeah. David Brenner, Sam Kinison. Let me just tell you about Snapple, all right? Hey, you guys try Snapple?
Oh.
Oh, yeah,
oh,
sure.
I was just telling yeah, David. Yeah. If I had some Snapple.
Yeah,
if
I had some Snapple.
The only thing missing.
Yes.
Snapple.
Yeah, this is great.
Snapple. Make the monkey drink the Snapple.
Hey, will like
hey,
like
the monkey
old
drink
Snapple.
The Snapple?
No, he wants it.
I don't know if that man speaks English.
I don't know. Let me go ask him. Hey, excuse me.
I would get the lemon.
He would?
Do you care?
Whoa.
Oh, no. Oh, the monkey doesn't care.
Hey, you did your...
He wants right. the bottle. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh,
see how good it is?
Oh, look right. at that.
Oh, see how healthy it is?
That's what...
I'll tell you something. Sam, looks like you on a Saturday night, huh? I'm telling you, it's unbelievable. Look how this... You see, this is nature, everybody. Snapple is so good that even...
Snapple probably helped with our evolution.
Even the primates themselves will see. Yes, Snapple will help our evolution,
that
Sam.
That monkey is going to turn into a man during this commercial.
This monkey will grow into a man. Finally, all those yahoos in the deep south
man.
Will realize how...
Big gorilla. Big gorilla. Put a big gorilla there.
You know what Snapple will do to the monkey system?
Give me five there, my friend. There you go. Very good.
Give me a Snapple.
He wants... Look, he's
there you go.
All
right.
Snapple!
Get away.
The monkey loves it.
See, what an endorsement.
You see, let me just say something.
He loves Snapple, man.
This proves once and for all how good Snapple is. When the animal kingdom responds to a drink, it could only be natural. The all-natural taste of real brewed Snapple. Thank you. Oh, we'll be back right after this. Stuttering John, anyway.
Is that right? What did they say about him?
Well, I don't know. They said that Stuttering John was pretty good. They like him. They like his guts. Actually, they say they like everything on the show, and then they say I shouldn't be on television.
Well, it's interesting. I understand that I didn't make the all-ugly team.
Yeah. That was that one reviewer said that this is an ugly, scraggly bunch, except for Robin Quivers, who is good-looking.
Well, I appreciate that.
Yeah, oh, that you like. Yeah, great.
That reviewer was right.
Ah, they're all skunks, I'll tell you that. I'm with David Brenner. But Stuttering John is here. The first one I got to play for you, this one is great.
You know, Roy Scheider is one of my favorite actors.
Well,
so I couldn't believe.
He's one of my favorites too. That's why it was kind of difficult doing this.
Yeah. You found Roy Scheider at a celebrity softball game, right?
What is it, John?
It was for
Women in Film.
Women in film. All right.
Put it. I'm sorry.
Take a look at this, Stuttering John with Roy Scheider. And the more nervous John gets, when I do a weird interview, I sort of feel like I have to urinate.
Well, that would be interesting.
Right, but you can't see that.
Yeah.
With John, it's the stutter.
Okay.
The more nervous he gets, the more he stutters. So here it is. Take a look at this.
Roy, can I ask you a few questions?
Sure.
Hi, it's from the Howard Stern Summer Show.
Hiya, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
Good.
I'm a big fan of yours. Jaws is my favorite movie of all time. What?
You don't have clearance. You did not come through.
Yes, we are. This press.
From whom?
From Channel 9. I don't understand the problem here. I have press release right here.
All right, I'm sorry, but I don't have you on an RSVP list for my press list. No one called me from the
WWE. Look, I had the same thing you do, only
what
nine
press. What show are you shooting for?
Howard Stern Summer Show, Channel 9.
Howard Stern Summer Show, I see. When did you RSVP? Because you didn't, and we really can't take this gentleman's time right now.
What do you mean you can't take his time?
I can't. I just told you.
I just told him how much of a big fan I am of Roy Scheider.
That's great. He's a wonderful actor, and
he really is.
I'm sure you are.
I went to NYU. I know more about his career than you do. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
I have no RSVP for your show to come here today, and it's by invitation only.
Right, I spoke to Bruce Campbell.
I'm sorry, then. That's my error.
Roy Scheider.
I was someone else that they had to RSVP to, and I did not speak to Bruce.
Oh. Okay.
I apologize.
Okay.
I just can't have people going if I don't know who they are.
No,
it's my responsibility.
I know I'm not dressed as like the normal press person. You know how it is. So, Roy,
press? Very press. That's very press.
What's your next movie that you're coming out with?
Russian House. Comes out in probably Thanksgiving.
Who else is
starring? Sean Connery, Michelle Pfeiffer.
Really?
You know, a couple of ringers.
Are you a married man?
Yes, I am.
Really, too? Anyone you know?
Come on, ask me some questions.
All right, here we go. Okay. Are you a Jew, Roy?
That won't do either.
Do you smoke pot?
That won't do.
Do you worship Satan?
That won't do either.
Do you think that Two Live Crew are talented or just another bunch of troublesome black guys?
They're a talented bunch, yeah.
Do you believe in the censorship thing?
I believe in no censorship.
So do I. I guess you're a Democrat, right?
That's right.
Same with me. Do you think that the Empire State Building should be bathed in lavender for the gays?
All week.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah. Why not? They make it green, don't they?
Do you think that Mandela hates Jews?
No.
What ethnic group is a number one?
Number one what?
You know, the supreme, you know.
I agree.
Why do they even bother putting hair and eye color on Chinese licenses?
I don't know why.
I'm asking you. All right, this is a really serious question.
All right.
What kind of material do you enjoy? What kind of shows do you enjoy reading in the toilet bowl?
Very serious Russian novels.
No, seriously. Mad Magazine?
Vanity Fair.
Yeah. All right, hey, man, thanks a lot, Roy. I appreciate it. I'm like a real big fan of yours, seriously. I love it. How are you?
Roy Scheider, a bodybuilder or what?
Huh?
Meeting of the mindless. I got another good one, though. This is a short one, and it's really kind of my favorite. When you go up to Joey Ramone. Joey Ramone, of course, the lead singer of the Ramones.
Yeah.
Who had...
Well, Joey didn't know that John was from our show.
Right.
So it was even more menacing to him.
Oh, dear.
Take a look at this tape. I think it's pretty cool.
You scared Joey Ramone?
Yeah. John actually scared Joey Ramone.
Go figure.
Hi, Joey. How you doing?
Hey, how are you?
This is for Channel 9 TV.
Joey appears to have straightened his hair.
Yeah, he used to look like you. Now he doesn't anymore.
Thank God. Because he really used to be my body double, and it was kind of upsetting. Nice look, huh?
Oh.
He's sort of doing a Cher thing, huh?
Sort of like a Chrissy Hynde kind of thing.
Yeah, very, very exciting look.
FM in New York. Are you a Jew?
What?
Are you a Jew?
What's it to you?
What? Huh?
What's it to you?
No, I'm just asking.
I don't understand what it has to do with anything.
Okay, all right. I'm sorry. Do you smoke pot?
No, I don't smoke pot.
All right. Thank you.
Oh.
Huh? Do we get the stars on this show?
Oh, boy.
I tell you. Do we have time for one more Paul Harvey one? I don't know. I'm hoping we do.
Can we?
We don't, I guess. All right. Well, we got to take a break. We got a lot of show to get to.
Yeah.
We got the news coming up. We got the Afros. Joe Walsh is going to do a couple of songs. Sam's going to come in and jam with us. If you want great television, of course, you have to have a rap group. I learned that from Arsenio. He sent me a fax just a few minutes ago.
Hey, it put him over the top, Howard.
And so I'm going to meet the Afros. The Afros actually have a philosophy. It's a rap group with a philosophy. They have like a minister.
They're political? Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah, they're political.
All right.
I'd like to welcome the Afros to the show here. Here they are. Where's my Afro?
Well, these guys are feeling wrong.
Hey, Afros. Hey, what's happening? Good seeing
you. These guys are wearing wigs, Howard.
I know. Now, let me ask you something. Your philosophy is what? To make money? Is that the philosophy of the group? Now, someone told me your philosophy as rap artist is that you believe in going back to naturals. natural hairstyles?
Well, you know, that's why we throw this fro on, because, you know, we different, you know? Trying to get back, because back then everybody was cool with that afro on, so, you know. We
but that's
we
a wig, though, good. Right?
Yeah, you're wearing wigs.
Aren't you?
But, you know, man, him, his is real.
That's
you
a
know?
Real afro.
Let pull it. Pull
could
it.
You pull on your afro?
Yeah, right, that's real.
No, I mean, but now you guys are supposedly happening, right? I mean, this is going to be it. You're going to get really big. Is that the idea? I mean, you got a big song out? We're going to take a look at your video and we'll analyze it. Because I want to analyze the lyrics, see if I could really get into it.
This is how we innovate.
Yeah, we want to be innovative.
By the way, I got a little t-shirt for you, man. It's an afro.
Howard, you were worried because you're wearing the same shirt you had on last week. Just rip that up and
put it on. You
know
something? It's so true. This is the right kind of look for me. It really is. Let me ask you guys something now. You guys making money yet? What record label are you on?
Well, we on
JMJ Records.
JMJ Records?
Yes, yeah. A new independent label distributed through RAL, Russell Simmons, Russ Associated Labels.
Yeah, I see.
Sounds impressive. I've never heard of it, but it sounds impressive.
Well, Russell Simmons is a very impressive name because he's the guy with Run
Russell,
DMC.
Russell just won on his house.
Yeah, that's right.
I thought you guys were on the Clarence Williams III label.
They have his hairdo, certainly.
Jim J. Bullock Records is the label I'm on. I've been recording with Jim J. Bullock Records for the last couple of weeks, to tell you the truth. But, no, I never heard of any of these guys, but I'm sure it's impressive.
Are you getting radio airplay?
Oh, yeah, we're the number two added song in the country.
What's the name of the song?
Feel It.
Feel It?
Yeah.
Or Feel It?
Feel It.
Feel It.
Feel It.
Feel It.
Feel It.
It sounded like Feel It when
you
said
it. Yeah, I thought it was Feel It.
How about going back to English, guys?
I thought they were singing about, you know, gas station attendants. Feel It.
So what do you guys do? Grow up poor and stuff? Like in the ghetto and stuff? Dude, wait, hey, did you guys,
just kidding,
come on, man, did you guys get raised in the ghetto? Now you're going to make some money?
Where did you grow up?
Where'd you grow up?
Grew up in Hollis, Queens. Hollis, Queens.
Everybody's from Hollis.
So you guys are middle class, that's bougie, right? That's, you guys didn't grow up in the ghetto, right?
Yeah, you know, it ain't, you know.
You the ghetto.
You ain't rich over there, man, you know, you got
nobody's
to make it out of there.
So you got a good home life, right? Your mother and father were home, and it wasn't the whole stereotype of just your grandmother raising you or something like that, right?
All that.
Oh, your grandmother did raise you?
All that.
Did your grandmother raise you?
No, my grandmother raised me.
Exactly.
I was
going to
say, how many generations?
My mother and grandmother raised me.
Your mother and grandmother. No father, or was
the
he
father
around?
Father, too.
Father, too. So there you go. So, see, these so guys, these guys, these guys.
They're not real black guys.
No, they're not.
What are you?
Where'd you learn to talk jive, then?
Are you a real black woman?
When you write these songs, do you think that it's God putting the words on the music? Because every black artist I see, they thank God whenever they win
award
an award.
Show.
Is God writing those raps, or is that coming from you?
Yeah. I'm writing my own raps.
So when you guys win a Grammy, you're not going to go up there and thank God. You're going to thank yourselves.
Exactly.
All right, let me get this straight now. Which one of you guys have had white women yet? Anybody?
I used to DJ for the Beastie Boys, so, you know, I've been through a lot.
You can get white women being a rap artist?
Well, you know, play, baby.
I mean, you guys are into every kind of racial group, right?
Yeah, you know,
no discrimination. No discrimination.
That's very beautiful.
Peace and love.
All right, I want to take a look at your video. Hold on a second. Let me see what this is all about.
Yeah, let's see what they do.
All right, I got a tape
the
right
afros.
Here.
The afros.
Kicking afrolistics.
Yes, I understand.
Play, baby.
Then we'll get back to the white women.
Why do I wear my afro? Because my hair don't grow. Can't you see? Or else
you guys are in pretty good shape.
This guy's bald.
Yeah. Who's that fat lady? Wait a second. I like it. I mean, it looks good to me. I don't know. It looks like it could be a hit.
You know,
I think it's going to be a big hit for you guys.
You know, we could have did anything, you know what I'm saying? Put purple makeup on our face, anything, just to be different, but we decided to be the frozen.
To have the afros.
Which we truly are, you know?
So you guys don't carve stuff into the side of your head like the Batman logo or something like this?
Nah, you know, just the fro, just, you know.
All natural.
So which one of you guys has had white women? Please raise your hand. That's all I want to know. Because that's supposed to be the prize. You know, everyone acts like that's the prize. You make it in the record business,
isn't
that's
that
the
why they went into the music business?
I'd like to give the afros a piece of advice before we go to break.
Okay.
What's up?
First of all, guys, you should, when you guys become very rich, you should stick with the black women. Because the black women is the future of the black community. Am I correct?
Absolutely.
Exactly.
You know, you should be a black man.
I really should.
Yeah,
I wonder, Robin, if I was a black man, would I go after white women if I made it? I don't know.
G-T-D-H.
Robin, is the guy on the right armed or what?
I don't know. He's the one who went to college, so I'm hoping he's not bagging a gun.
We're going to take a break. We got some news coming up for you. Joe Walsh, okay? Don't go away. The afros is going to be a big hit, man. I'm telling you right now. There it is, the afros.
Yeah.
By the way, we're going to do some news now. Joe Walsh is coming up. Sam Kinison's going to come by. We're going to do a couple of Eagles songs at the end of the show.
We're going to jam. They call that a jam session. We're going to gig.
We're going to gig on a Casio. All right. Robin, what's in the news for Saturday night?
Well, Howard, you know, I've been a little bit concerned about what's been going on at the jogger trial. Have you been watching any of that?
Yeah.
They have these three black kids on trial for the rape of a woman in Central Park. And one of these kids, Yousef Salam, always shows up at the jogger trial with his mom. Mm-hmm. And she's appeared in the newspaper several times. She has a very distinctive page boy kind of natural do with the braids and all that stuff. So she's an interesting looking woman. And you never really get to hear her talk. But she's been saying she's been brutalized by the press. So we have a little bit of tape here of her entering the courtroom one day. Let's go with this.
I haven't been following this story. I've been in my pool all week.
So. Oh, really? Haven't had time. Well, here she is. She's walking in now. She just bumps into the cameraman.
Stop talking at me. Get the police. Get the police here. Police.
Whoa, man.
But it's interesting. I slowed this down.
Yeah.
So we can look at it, and you tell me, is she walking into the cameraman or not?
Okay. Here we go. Watch carefully, please.
There you go. There she is. Now, all of a sudden, she's turning.
Did she crash into the camera?
Watch this. She's headed right. She can see him. Look.
Boom. Oh. She walked into him.
Yeah.
And elbows him right in the gut.
Oh, and then he grabs her breath.
Ooh. Ooh.
Pushes him again.
Yeah. So then she has a little conference with the press.
Right.
To talk about this incident.
Hmm. Let's see what she has to say, for God's sake. Her son is brutal. She really defending this guy or what?
You saw the man try to assault me going inside? I was standing back here and saying, yes, this is just another sign of camera brutality. You're trying to get in here to make a court appearance. You're already under death threat, and the camera people tried to attack you going inside the court proceeding so you can't even get in there.
Now, this is a new phenomenon. Camera brutality.
Yeah, I've been the victim of that myself.
Okay. I hadn't heard of this.
I want to talk about camera brutality. Last week, there were about three bad close-ups on me, and I looked a mess. So let's end camera brutality, particularly camera number two. You don't have to come in on my left side.
So you've been a victim of this as well.
Everybody's like Al Sharpton now, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. She's Al Sharpton with jugs. Everybody's Al Sharpton. Yeah, everyone's
camera
got a call.
Camera brutality.
Yeah, right.
So anyway, you know, there are also a whole group of supporters.
Right.
Of the kids who are on trial, and they have been attending the trial every day. We tried to interview them, but they refused to talk to the press, apparently because of camera brutality, this new phenomenon. Right. But we have got a little bit of tape of them screaming and protesting the defense attorneys after the jogger testified in the courtroom because the defense attorneys did not cross-examine her.
All right. How could you be for these kids? I mean, why would you condone
the so-called victims? Do you not know that? Fellow!
Why do you say that? Tell me,
get away from me!
Why do you feel that these people are sold out? Do you feel these attorneys are doing inadequate?
They never ask a question. When she came there, look at the way they do it. I could do a better case than that. I could handle that better. I could do a better job than them. I don't know a damn thing about the law.
What country are these guys from?
They
come to this country to defend these kids? You know, that looked like Arsenio's audience.
That's what they're doing during the day.
I'm telling you. I'm not kidding.
If you ask for that dog's hand, I think they could do it. But anyway, so that's what's happening with the jogger case. She testified this week, and then they speared her out. And apparently, the supporters of the defendants thought it was either an actress, or, you know, that she should have been cross-examined.
Right.
So that's what's going on in that trial. Also, recently, there were Lucy tryouts.
Lucy.
You know, they're doing this new movie for CBS called Lucy and Desi Before the Laughter.
Yeah.
So they're doing open casting calls across the country, and it was our turn. So we had a bunch of people come in to some central location to do their auditions to be Lucy and Desi.
Good, because I saw this in the newspaper, and not one woman looked like Lucy.
Well, let's see what's going on. Here's the whole lineup.
Yeah.
A lot of people standing outside. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, we have Desi inside.
Get out of here. Boom, 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 boom Oh, hey, that looks like
and then we get a bunch of Lucy's.
That's Lucy? Is that Lucy after she's been cold cocked?
Well, this is supposed to be the early years. I don't think anybody told this woman.
Oh, I see. This is like Lucy after she married Gary Morton, huh? This is like Lucy playing the woman who got attacked in Central Park.
I thought it was Lucy after she's gone.
Yeah, right. The dead Lucy.
You remember the bit about Bill Holden?
Sure. Who's playing Bill Holden for you? Do you bring your own talent with you, or are you just mime at all?
No, I'm going to just mime at all. I mean, I'm an actress, right?
Lucy is the elephant woman. Robin.
This is the one who's going to play Lucy, though.
Oh, I see.
She could play Ricky.
She could play Ricky?
Like I said, I love Lucy. I've watched her for years, and I'm a good actress, if I have to say so myself. Mm. I've always been a natural, a comedian, and like I say, I can do most people, you know. I'm very good at
She could play Sinbad. Sinbad! God's sake.
You know, interpreting people. So, yeah, I really think I have a good chance.
Oh, that's a Lucy?
And then this woman does her own impression.
Ricky, seeing another woman.
Oh, I knew about a little woman. Oh, what is that?
Woman.
What is that?
I don't think they're going to find Lucy in this bunch.
Robin, I do a better Lucy.
Ricky, I don't want to go home. I want to go to the show, Ricky.
Well, you at least have the voice. You at least have the voice.
That's the news. We're taking a break. Joe Walsh is here next. Kinison's right. Going to drop back in, too, for a little jamming.
Yeah.
Jamming. We love to jam here on Saturday night.
Thank you.
Sam Kinison, Joe Walsh.
Yes.
How you doing?
By the way, Joe, now what's the deal?
Well, I think that monkey and Arsenio go to the same hairdresser. Did
Is that
you
right? Did you
that?
See the Batman logo carved into the monkey's head? Is that what that was?
When I made peace with the man.
Do you notice that Joe looks different? You know, Joe,
yes, I do.
Sam, of course, now
of course.
Is off drink and drugs, right?
Me
no,
too.
You're not?
Just off drugs. I still drink a little bit.
Oh, he still drinks, but you're off everything now.
Yeah.
Right?
A little
you're
bit.
You're off everything?
Yeah.
Joe is like, uh-huh. Joe is completely healthy now.
Now
yes, you don't mind like taking a urinalysis test, right?
Now that I've quit drinking, I can enjoy a cocktail, you know?
Yeah. Joe Walsh, of course, legendary Eagles.
Well, wow. Are you back in the reunion? I heard that you're getting together and everything's okay?
Is Irving part of that?
Yeah.
Okay.
There is an Eagles reunion?
Yes.
Are you going to be in it?
We've pretty much resolved any internal differences, if there ever were any.
Why didn't they want you?
Oh, they want me.
They do.
Here,
I'm in.
Let me say two words that'll scare Joe.
I'm in.
Band meeting.
Yeah.
What do you mean? I don't get it. I don't get it.
No, we're having real good dialogue, and I would think it look around for us sometime next year.
Oh, if you did Desperado for us now, would it make Don Henley mad?
Yeah.
It would.
Would he reassess again?
Would you do it for us now?
Sure.
Oh, you would. You don't care. That's good. Because this could be a very beautiful moment.
Yeah.
It's a good way Don Henley singing in a dressing room somewhere, you know?
Yeah. He's playing it.
Did you hear about Chuck Berry? He's in trouble.
Yeah, I heard about that with white women.
200 women are suing him for being videotaped in the bathroom of his restaurant.
What's his restaurant called? Chuck's?
Chuck's. Yeah. Chuck's and white women.
No, yeah. Chuck's big boy.
Chuck's big boy. That's it. Joe, you want to do it?
If you like.
All right, here it is. Sam, you ready?
Now.
Come down from your fences, holy today. Oh, you're a hard one. I know that you got your reason. There's things that are pleasing you, hurt you strongly. Don't you draw. A girl you never met. What's the word? Oh, yeah. It seems to me some fine things have been laid upon your table, but you always want the one you can get. Desperado, down from your fences. Holy today, it may be raining. There's a rainbow above you. You better let somebody love you. Let somebody love you. Better let somebody love you before it's too.
Hey, by the way, join us next week. We'll be doing something wacky, and we didn't get to a couple of things, like talking to Dartman and setting up the blind guy and all that stuff. But we're going to do that next week. Join us for the Howard Stern Summer Special next week. And I'd also like to thank Sam Ash for the musical instruments. We spared no expense, Joe, with this beautiful cast.
Can I predict?
Thanks, Sam.
Can I predict? It's cult. The show is cult. I just want to go on record as saying this show is cult. This show will be cult.
Does that mean...
That's good. That's good.
That is good.
Cult is good.
Cult sounds
fresh,
like... Dude.
No, it'll be the same thing with that Richard Pryor TV show. There'll be five or six good episodes that nobody will ever see.
You know, milk commercial stuff.
Right.
Man.
No Rick D's.
This is cult, babe. This is cult.
All right. We'll see you next time.
This is Videodrome. Oh!